Hi, kumusta? This is your Eman, a public school science teacher. In this video, we will learn another interesting lesson in Science 9. Kaya kung gusto mong matuto, make sure na panoorin at tapusin mo ang video na ito. In this video, we will discuss about momentum and impulse. Now, this is based on the 21st most essential learning competency in Science 9, which is relate impulse and momentum to collision of objects, say for instance, vehicular collision. So ready ka na ba? Tara, simulan na natin. I want you to take a look at this illustration we have on the screen. So what do you see on our picture? Well, you probably would say that you see here a truck and a car. Now, let's say these two vehicles are moving and suddenly they lose their brakes and crash in against the wall that you can see on the screen. Now, which do you think between the two collisions would result to more damage? Sige nga, palagay nyo, anong kaya ang magiging more damaging between the two collisions? Well, probably most of you would answer that it is the collision between your truck and the brick wall. Now, what factor did you consider in deciding for your answer? So assuming, let's say, that these two objects or vehicles are actually moving in the same speed, anong pinagbasihan nyo kung alin yung magiging more damaging, alin yung magiging less damaging? So sige, keep your answer. Tingin natin mamaya kung kaparehas yan nung ating pag-uusapan ngayong umaga na to or in this video. Now, I want you to take a look at this second illustration that we have on the screen. So ano naman this time yung nakikita nyo? Probably seeing here two identical vehicles or cars, one numbered 4 and the other numbered 7. Okay, now let's say that car A, the one with number 7, is traveling at a speed of 80 kilometers per hour, while car B, the one that is numbered 4, is traveling at 30 kilometers per hour. Which do you think between the two is much more difficult to stop? Ano kaya mas mahirap patigilin sa dalawa? Is it car A or car B? Now, most of you probably answered car A, or the one with number 7 that is moving at 80 kilometers per hour. Now again, what factor did you consider in deciding for your answer, assuming that these two are indeed identical in terms of their mass? Kapareho sila ng bigat. Sige nga. Okay, you keep your answer again and let's find out later kung kapareho yan ng ating pag-uusapan sa ngayon. Now, what we're talking about in these two illustrations in terms of which one will have the most impact or damage or the one that is more difficult to stop actually has something to do with what we call momentum. Okay, well, these objects or vehicles that you have chosen a while ago, the truck, and in this second illustration, the car with number 7, letter A, both these vehicles actually have higher momentum compared to the other vehicles in their respective illustrations. So what then is momentum? Well, basically, momentum is a moving body's or moving object's tendency to resist any change in its state of motion. Okay, it's a tendency of an object to stay moving. Okay, that's why it is also referred to as inertia in motion. Well, inertia is the tendency of an object to resist changes in its state of motion. Yung tendency ng object na i-resist yung pagbabago sa kanyang state of motion. Kung siya ay nakatigil, tendency na patuloy siya maging at rest. At kung siya ay in motion, tendency ng object na patuloy na mag-move. So when you speak of momentum, ito yung tendency ng isang object na patuloy na mag-move. Ano? At i-resist yung changes sa kanyang state of motion. That is why it basically tells us how hard it is to stop or how difficult it is to stop a moving object. Now, momentum depends on two factors, and those two factors are mass and velocity. Now, let's again take a look at those illustrations that I have shown you a while ago. Let's have the first one. So, for bodies moving at the same velocity, the more massive body has greater inertia in motion, therefore, has greater momentum. So, in this figure one, if both the truck and the car are moving at the same velocity, so they are moving, we assume that they are moving at the same velocity and they both lose their brakes, the truck would cause more damage on the wall by virtue of its mass, because it's more massive. So they have the same velocity, but the truck is more massive. That's why it has more, greater momentum, and it's much difficult to stop. And since it's much difficult to stop, it definitely will result to more damage. Okay. Now let's proceed this time to the second illustration. So for moving bodies with the same mass, the faster body has greater inertia in motion, therefore has greater momentum. Kanina, kung constant ang velocity, pagkapareho, determine kung sino ang mas mataas ang momentum would be the mass. Now, sa pangalawa naman, kung constant ang kanyang mass, ang mag-determine naman kung ang mas mataas ang momentum would be the speed. So, kung sino mas mabilis, siya yung mas mataas ang momentum. So, in this figure, figure 2, cars A and B have the same mass. But since car A has greater velocity, it therefore has greater inertia in motion, resulting to greater momentum, making it more difficult to stop than car B. Okay, so nakuha po? Hopefully, nakuha. Now, we made mention that momentum is dependent on two factors, right? Your mass and your velocity. Well, momentum is actually a product of its mass, an object's mass, and its velocity. As in the equation P, which represents your momentum, is equal to M times V. So M represents your mass, and V represents your velocity. So if you will be able to see in the problem, units such as kilograms, then that's for mass. If you see units just meter per second, then that is for velocity. Now let us try solving problems involving momentum. So let's have this first sample problem. Let me read it first. So what is the momentum of a 20 kilogram grocery cart which travels at 1.2 meters per second? You will answer this systematically. You will follow the GFSA method, starting off with the given value. So what are the given values in this problem? So you have 22 kilograms. You see the unit kilogram, so this pertains to the mass. And then another one, you have 1.2 meters per second. So you see the unit meter per second, so this pertains to the velocity. So we're asked to find the momentum. So momentum is represented by small letter P. What is the formula that we're going to use? We have P is equal to mv, mass times velocity. So solution, we will simply have to substitute the given values. So we're looking for the P, so M, that's equivalent to 22 kilograms, times the velocity, which is 1.2 meters per second. So multiplying this to 22 times 1.2, you have here, the answer is 26.4, the unit, don't forget the unit, kilogram meter per second. So basically, we just combine the unit for mass and the unit for velocity. Okay, so that is how easy it is to compute for the momentum of a moving object. Okay, we simply multiply the mass and the velocity. So let's try another sample problem. So let me read this first. What is the momentum of a child in a wagon if the total mass of the child in the wagon is 31 kilograms and the velocity is 1.5 meters per second? So let's list first the given values. So you see here, 31 kilograms. With 31 kilograms, you see the unit kilograms. So it pertains to the mass, okay? So it's the mass of both the child and the wagon because they're moving together, okay? And then you have 1.5 meters per second. You see the unit meters per second. So this pertains to the velocity. So again, we're asked to find the momentum P. Formula to be used, same. P is equal to mass times velocity. Solution, we simply substitute the given values. P is equal to, what is the mass? 31 kilograms. Times the velocity, which is 1.5 meters per second. So if we multiply this to 31 times 1.5, we will arrive at an answer which is 46.5 kilograms meter per second. Okay, let's have the last sample problem. Okay, a bowling ball is of 35.2 kilograms generates 218 kilograms meter per second units of momentum. Now, what is the velocity of the ball? So let's identify first the given values. You see here, 35.2 kilograms. So definitely, you see the unit kilogram, it pertains to the mass. Now, what about this 218 kilogram meter per second? So this is not simply meter per second. You already have their kilogram. So this is the unit for momentum. So your 218 kilogram meter per second, that's the momentum. So what is being asked in the problem, that is the velocity. So dito, hindi yung momentum ang hinahanap, yung velocity naman daw. Kung ito yung bigat, ito yung kanyang momentum, ano yung, gaano kabilis yung takbo ng object na to? So what formula are we going to use? So of course, we will start with still, P is equal to mass times velocity. But this time, we're not looking for the momentum, but we're looking for the velocity. So we will have to derive the formula. Okay, we will have to rearrange the quantities here. Okay, so since the one being asked is the velocity, so we will have to isolate that on one side. So to do that, ito natin, on one side, you have mass and velocity. Para matanggal natin yung mass, we will have to divide both sides by mass. Okay, so pag dinivide natin both sides by mass, mawawala na yung mass dun sa katabi ng velocity, mapapunta siya sa ilalim ng ating momentum. So we will have velocity is equal to momentum over mass. The solution, we will simply have to substitute the given values. We have V is equal to P over M, or momentum over the mass. So you have there 218 kilogram meter per second divided by 35.2 kilograms. So we will be able to cancel the unit kilogram. So we will only have meters per second. So 218 divided by 35.2, we will arrive at an answer which is 6.19 meters per second. Okay, so that is how fast the object is, the bowling ball is actually moving. Okay, to be able to generate a momentum of 218 kilogram meter per second. Okay. So far, are there questions? What about points of clarification? So hopefully, there are none. Pero kung may mga parts na hindi pa masyadong malinaw, pwedeng balikan nyo ito. Yung mga parts na yan. Okay? Now, in physics, an external force acting on an object over a specific time leads to a change in the momentum of an object. So we need to say, if you want to change the momentum of an object, there has to be an application of an external force over a specific period of time. Now, there is actually a specific name that is given to the product of the force applied in the time interval during which this force acts, and that is what we call impulse. Now, given this definition, we will arrive at the formula for impulse, which is force times time. Okay? Now, as we've mentioned, the application of this external force acting on an object over a specific time leads to a change in momentum. Sabi natin kanina, force times time, that is the impulse. And that leads to the change in momentum. So we can say that impulse as well is the change in momentum. So if we're going to combine the formula for impulse that we had a while ago, force times time, and the fact that it is equal to the change in momentum, we will have this complete formula. So force times time, that is impulse, is equal to the change in momentum, which is represented by P. So if we're going to further expand this, we will have the formula Ft, or F times time, force times time is equal to mass, open parenthesis, Vf minus Vi. So saan ang galing sir itong mass times Vf minus Vi? Diba sabi natin, change in momentum. Now, pag nagkakaroon ng change in momentum, diba sabi natin that is affected by two factors, your mass and your velocity. So most of the time naman, nagbabago yung momentum ng isa, hindi dahil biglang nagbago yung timbang ng moving objects. For instance, tayo tumatakbo. So hindi naman nagbabago yung momentum dahil bigla tayo nag-lose ng weight, nag-lose tayo ng agad-agad ng 5 kilograms, 10 kilograms. Hindi ganun. Most of the time, ang factor na nagko-cause is the change in velocity. Nagbago yung momentum kasi constant pa rin naman yung mass, kaya lang bigla ka nagbago ng bilis. Okay? That's why, as you can see here, we were able to arrive at this equation, mass times your final velocity minus your initial velocity. Now, let's try to solve problems involving impulse. Let's try this first sample problem. So, let me read this first. A cart is pushed with a force of 25 newton in 4 seconds, which caused it to move. What is the impulse imparted on the cart? So, let's identify first the given values. So, you see here, 25 newton. So, anong quantity ang tinutukoy nitong 25 newton? So, if you see right away the unit newton, this actually pertains to the force, okay? And then you have your 4 seconds, you see the unit seconds, definitely that pertains to the time. So, you have 25 newton, the force, and then 4 seconds, the time. So, what is being asked in this problem is the impulse, which is represented by letter I. Now, what formula are we going to use in solving for the impulse? So impulse is equal to force times time. That's the formula that I have shown you a while ago. So we will simply have to multiply the force times the time. For the solution, we will simply have to substitute the given values. So force, that's equivalent to 25 Newton, and then your time, which is represented by 4 seconds. So multiplying 25 times 4, 100, and then you combine the two units, your Newton and your second. So basically, this is the impulse that the cart was able to acquire with the force that you have applied given this specific time. So this 100 Newton second is the change in momentum that the cart experienced from rest until it moved. Okay. Well, as for the unit Newton second, this is actually same with kilogram meter per second. As you can remember a while ago, that is the unit for momentum. Diba? Impulse, that's the change in momentum. Well, how are we going to arrive at that unit? Newton basically is equivalent to kilogram meter per second squared. This is basically mass times acceleration. So kilogram meter per second squared. So if we're going to combine this kilogram meter per second squared times another second, so you have second squared, which is in the denominator, we will be able to cancel one of the second in the denominator. So we will arrive at simply kilogram meter per second. Now let's have the second sample problem. What impulse is needed to change the speed of a 10 kilogram body from 20 meter per second to 12 meter per second? So diba, impulse, that's the change in momentum. So ano yung impulse na kailangan na ma-experience para itong 10 kilogram na moving body ay mag-slow down from 20 to 12. So let's identify first the given values. So you have 10 kilograms, given the unit itself, that is already the mass. And then your 20 meter per second, dalawa, yung may 20 meter per second dito. Diba? Kanina sa formula, meron tayong VF at merong VI. So dito, gagamit tayo ng mga keywords. Sabi dito, from 20 meter per second to 12 meter per second. Dalawa lang naman yun, final at initial velocity. So, alin yung magiging initial velocity natin? Ano yung kanyang una na bilis? Sabi, from, mula 20 meter per second papunta, magiging 12 meter per second na lang. So, alin sa dalawa ang ating initial velocity? So, definitely, that is 20 meter per second. And then, the final velocity is your 12 meter per second. So, given this, we're asked to find the impulse. What formula are we going to use? So, kanina, yung I is equal to force times time. Pero dito, pagkasamahin natin yung ating pangalawang binigay sa inyo na formula, which we have I is equal to mass times VF minus VI. Because impulse is the change in momentum. So, we're simply going to substitute the given values. You have your mass, 10 kilograms, and then your VF, which is 12 meter per second, kulang na sa aming unit, minus 20 meter per second. So, in this case, if we are going to perform this operation, 12 minus 20, we will have negative 8, right? That's negative 8. So negative 8 times 10, you have here negative 80 kilogram meter per second. Basically, this signifies that the object decreased in its velocity. Ano kaya siya naging negative? Kasi bumagal. Let's have the third sample problem. An offensive player passes a football of mass 0.42 kilograms with a velocity of 25 meter per second due south. If the player is in contact with the ball for 0.05 seconds, what is the magnitude of the average force he exerts? Okay, let's have the given value. So, meron tayong 0.42 kilograms. Automatically, that pertains to the mass because of the kilograms. And then we have here 25 meter per second. So, assuming, di ba, yun daw offensive na player, kanyang pinasa yung football of mass 0.42 kilograms with a velocity of 25 meter per second. So, initially, zero ang velocity nun. Zero, yun na yung initial velocity mo agad. At sa pagpapasa niya, binigyan niya yung object ng velocity niya, 25 meter per second. So, yung 25 meter per second, that is your final velocity. Ang initial velocity mo dito would be zero. And then, for the time, ito naman natin, you have your 0.5 seconds. We're asked to find the force. So, anong formula gamitin dito? You have force times time is equal to mass times Vf minus Vi. Now, ang hinahanap dito would be the force. Kaya lang, on one side, you see, magkasama pa yung force at time. So, we'll have to isolate just the force. So, to do that, we will divide both sides by the time. So, dito, makakancel natin yung time at makapunta siya sa kabila. That's why we will have F is equal to mass times Vf minus Vi, and yung buong yun divided by the time. So, let's substitute the given values. So, you have here yung ating mass, 0.42 kilograms, and then Vf minus Vi, 25 meter per second minus 0 meter per second, and then yung buong yun divided by 0.05 seconds. So, performing the operation, 25 minus 0 is still 25 times 0.042, and then kapag nakuha na, divided by 0.05. We will arrive at an answer which is 210 kilogram meter per second squared. Okay? Or this is the same as Newton. And ito yung pinakita ko sa inyo kanina. Kapag ang unit ay kilogram meter per second squared, that is force. Pero pag simply kilogram meter per second, that is either momentum or impulse. Okay? So that's basically how we were able to arrive at this answer. Changes in momentum happen every time. Lahat, halos ng mga bagay sa paligid natin, they're always on the move. Tayo, mga sasakyan, mga iba't ibang mga hayop, at iba't ibang mga bagay. Ano? And so, this momentum and impulse actually have a lot of applications in real life. Now, see, for instance, a fast-moving car, when suddenly stopped, might have damaging effects, not only to the vehicles itself, but also to the person riding it. Kaya in a vehicle, there are a lot of features or devices which are installed to decrease the damage which may be a result of possible accidents or collision. One feature of a vehicle which does that is actually the seatbelt. When a vehicle suddenly stops, it experiences impulse or change in momentum. So, ano ginagawa ng seatbelt? So, they are designed to keep car occupants inside the car where it's likely to be safer during a crash. Kasi probably, pag nagkaroon ng aksidente, magkakaroon ng pagbabago bigla sa state of motion noong sasakyan, yung katawan ng isa, kung hindi naka seatbelt, pwede yung patuloy na mag-move forward. But because of the seatbelt, it keeps the body still inside intact of the inside of the car. And they stretch just a bit, helping to increase the time it takes for the impulse to be absorbed. So basically, another feature that it does is to extend the time. Diba sabi natin kanina, impulse is a product of the force and the time. So yung dalawang factor lang naman ang nagko-control nun. So what it does is to extend the time para pag na-extend yung time, yung force of impact ay magiging mas mababa. So to illustrate that, this is a table showing the combination of force and time required to produce 100 units of impulse. So you see, yung impulse niya pare-pareho. Pero given yung iba't ibang combination nitong force at time, habang tumataas yung time, yung force ay bumababa. So basically, ito yung principle na sinusunod dito sa seatbelt. Pinapataas nila yung time, pinapatagal, para sa ganun, yung force of impact mababa na rin. Okay, so less yung magiging damage dun sa tao na nakasakay. Well, in sports, this is also applicable. We have what we call riding the punch. So when a boxer recognizes that he will be hit in the head by the opponent, the boxer often relaxes his neck and allows his head to move backwards upon impact. So, hindi niya sinasalubong yun. Ano, ang sabi dito, uti-uti, nire-relax niya yung kanyang neck at nag-move backward. So, ano yung principle behind that? A boxer rides the punch in order to extend the time of impact. So again, pinapahaba yung time of impact resulting in the decrease of force, minimizing the effect of the force and the collision. Okay, well, there are a lot of applications of this impulse and momentum in real life. Sa sasakyan, marami pang ibang mga features na nandun to minimize the damage, the force, to decrease the force. And as well as in sports, marami pang application ito. So you can do your research for you to further enrich your knowledge on this. Okay, so this ends our video for this week. Hopefully, naintindihan yung ating lesson. If there are certain points na hindi pa ganun kalinaw, pwede niyong balikan ano mamaya para mas maunawaan. So thank you for watching and see you on our next one. Bye!